Gino, we've got some breaking news here, and it's quarter horse news. So accordingly, we're going to bring Mike Joyce into the conversation right now. Mike, good morning to you. Thanks for joining us here on the Morning Line. And we understand that this has to do with one of the signature races at Los Al, the Champion of Champions.
Yeah, it was just announced today. They had an announcement on the loudspeaker from the racing office onto the backstretch at Los Alamitos that they're going to cancel the Champion of Champions for 2014. They are now going to run the Z-Wing Griffin Invitational, which will be of a much smaller purse size, and there will be a holiday handicap as well. But the Champion of Champions is not going to run in 2014.
And what essentially is the reasoning behind the cancellation?
Well, you know, it's been an ongoing battle for Los Alamitos against. They're basically trying to eradicate the sport of any untoward use of pharmaceuticals. Essentially, there has been allegations of cheating, and we've seen some very suspicious runs, especially with two-year-olds earlier this year. Now, what's happened, and Doc made an announcement about this. They sent out a press release a couple of weeks ago. Doc Allred said that from here on out, there will be no horses allowed to run in any races at Los Alamitos that have any detectable amount of clenbuterol in their system over the last 6 to 9 months. And the reason that there's that 6 to 9 month time period is because they're doing hair testing. So they've banned clenbuterol from use in quarter horse racing at Los Alamitos this year. It's been all year long, and there's been out of competition testing periodically through the year for horses stabled at Los Alamitos. That still wasn't good enough because there were horses that were shipping in that weren't stable at Los Al that they believe were, you know, getting through those rules by training on clenbuterol and then withdrawing it enough time to have those horses perform at a really high level, basically an unfair advantage. Now, it does need to be noted that this is not a substance that is banned in horse racing throughout. It's essentially a house rule, but it's also sanctioned by the CHRB and the LA QHBA, the Los Alamitos Quarter Horse Association. So this has been something, and there's a lot of people that have applauded their efforts, especially at Allred's efforts to eradicate the sport of cheating. And, you know, he's taking a hard line. He's taking a really hard line. And it's just, the result of which is any horses that have raced in jurisdictions where clenbuterol is allowed, such as Texas or New Mexico or Oklahoma, they're not going to be able to pass a hair test because they're racing in jurisdictions where they're allowed to use clenbuterol, which is a bronchial dilator, which is sanctioned and you can use, and there's allowable race day limits. However, at Los Al, you can have zero, and now they've actually hardened that to a hair test. So essentially, the field for that race has fallen apart, so they canceled it this year. But it's just a testament to how far the lengths they're willing to go to clean up the sport and to get this, you know, this bad taste and this bad image that's haunted our sport for the last couple of years.
Mike, let me ask you this, because you're a close observer of the sport of quarter horse racing. How do you reckon at this point that what Doc Allred is doing at Los Alamitos is being received in terms of the industry as a whole? And what is the hope going forward, that this will resonate and cause a ripple effect in other jurisdictions?
Well, I think, you know, like anything else, when you take a hard line on this, there's going to be people who love what you're doing and hate what you're doing. There's no middle ground. People aren't just okay with it or think maybe this is the right thing. There are people that love it and there are people that hate it. Now, the thing is that there are horsemen that he is protecting who are honest horsemen who do the right thing, that have been at a competitive disadvantage, that are also going to be upset about this because they're saying, well, we're not getting a fair chance to run at our, you know, big money days and our big races because, you know, we have taken our horses to different states to compete there, and we've, you know, applied, you know, we've complied with the rules of racing everywhere we've been, but coming back here, you know, we can't run. So there's people that are going to be against it that, you know, he's actually trying to protect and he's actually trying to maintain, you know, a competitive balance across the board. So, you know, and there's some people that are, you know, there's a lot of people, especially when you go to like social media and you look at, you know, in response to the stories on Pollock Report or Daily Racing Form or any of the places where it's been reported, there have been people that have been in tremendous support of Doc because, look, there's not a lot of racetrack owners, there's not a lot of people in this industry that are willing to go to the lengths that he is going. I mean, look at how far they're going. They're going to the point of canceling the Champion of Champions rather than have it be tainted by any fashion of cheating. And the Champion of Champions is really caught in the crosshairs here because it's more of the cheating that we've seen and more of the alleged cheating, I should say alleged, because nothing's really been proven yet. Has happened in the two-year-old ranks with Futurities. And essentially the thought is, you know, you see a trainer who's never qualified, you know, more than one horse to a Futurity in his life qualify five on one of the biggest nights, or a trainer who, you know, never trained any of these horses come in with, you know, 15 in the trial.
Mike, we're up against the opener. Mike Joyce joining us. Mike, we're up against the opener at the Big A. One more quick question before we let you go, and thanks for joining us. Contextualize this for those of our viewers who are not necessarily followers of quarter horse racing. What would this be similar to in the thoroughbred world?
It's very direct. They canceled the Breeders' Cup Classic.
Yeah, yep. All right, Mike, thanks very much. We look forward to further updates from you on this topic as it evolves. But there you go. The Champion of Champions canceled for 2014. Doc Allred taking a very hard line with
Thank
regard
you.
To clenbuterol use. Thanks, Mike.
Yeah, Mike Joyce has already been a busy man. He was on the radio early this morning talking about Del Mar on opening day. He's going to be working hard all throughout the afternoon. Thanks to Mike for helping us out.
Let's kick things off at the Big A. Good luck if you're playing the Pick Five.